They were great. Give yourselves a round of hands for being a great audience. It does look like fun. There's lots of other shows coming up. Wit has a run starting very soon called Seasonal Disorder. You guys probably all saw the decorations. They look even better now that they've been working out there while we've been in here. There are also classes. You can get involved. Meet a lot of fun people. Get a chance to try this out. WitDC.org for all the information about tickets for those Seasonal Disorder shows. Herald Night is every Tuesday. We do this for great audiences like you. And if you really want to get involved, after the next performance, there will be an open jam here on the stage. So stick around. But right now we have another great team coming to the stage for you. So give it up for WorkWife!
And to get started, we just need a word that makes you happy.
Plumbing.
Sparkle.
Balance.
What's that?
Plumbing.
Yeah. Plumbing.
Plumbing.
Okay.
Plumbing.
This is my dream house. I just bought it with my own money, and it feels so great to just have some place that's my own. I'm not renting or leasing, or there's no parents around.
You are so independent.
I am. There is no boss of me. No one except myself.
It's so great of you to bring us to this very selective housewarming.
Yeah, because you're just all my closest friends, and I just want to keep you guys close, but, you know, make sure you guys know that you're not any control over me.
Oh, no, there's a distance.
Yeah.
If you want to eat all that bread, just eat it.
Yeah.
I will, right now.
Yeah. Cool.
So,
let's go. So the murder weapon was a lead pipe, as you can see here. I look at this, it just makes me feel like, makes me feel rage.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
I try to place myself inside the head of the person to understand their perspective when I'm sort of decomposing what happened, or deconstructing as the body decomposes.
Yeah. Yeah.
A lot of D words.
I'm getting flashes of, what is that? It's a peacock. I'm getting flashes of the peacock right there, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
It kind of came to me.
Huh. Some sort of foul play.
Ah, yeah. Oh, yes. Yes. Right. Play, because we're in a billiard room.
Mm-hmm. What?
Yeah.
Duh.
It works on a couple different levels.
Yes. Man, doesn't it just grind your gears when these guys get away with it? Like when you can't get them?
If I could decompensate the situation, then I could arrive at the D.
Yeah.
It's all right. Hey, it's all right.
Yeah.
But Mr. Head Detective, will you catch him?
I always catch them.
Yeah, you do.
Or a try.
This is my new belt.
Ooh,
oh, yes. It represents a deep pride in one's heritage. You see, it's woven by the hands of my grandmothers, both of them, woven together. Yes, they spent long hours doing this for me, and it's good to connect with you. Connect with the people. Connect with who you are, you know? Love yourself.
I often ask myself, is there a better sign of family than clothing? No, there isn't.
There is absolutely not, no.
Clothing.
And at this country club, you are representing your lineage. Doesn't that make you proud?
That's right. No, that's how I got into this country club. My grandmother's, yeah. Long-time members. Yes, both of them together.
Were your grandfathers?
No. Absolutely not. No, they are very antisocial people. My grandmothers, so, though, made a lot of friends.
And belts.
And belts. Yeah, well, same thing, right?
Fine. Okay. She's just someone telling me where to sit.
I can't, Karen.
I'm sorry.
I
know that you're just a roommate, but I'm just used to having parents. So like, I don't know if you could just have like a guide me gently through like the living. by myself process?
I mean,
I'm usually asked to be excused from the table and like when I can sit.
I appreciate that, sure, like good manners, fine, but like seriously, like you can't keep like tucking you in, like it's sophomore. I've indulged this far too long at this point, okay?
I'm sorry, it's just like I'm an only child and just was like all the focus was on me. It's just like,
all right, if I'm gonna get your backstory every
like,
time we sit down to dinner, okay, Karen?
Golly.
Sorry.
Can't we just, let's like talk about something normal, like,
yeah.
Like, professor.
My mom. she's so warm. She's just so warm.
No, I'm very aware of how warm your mother is. She actually, stayed with us last weekend.
she
ended up in my bed and just kind of cuddled up.
You know, she's a
around
bad
me
bath, so she,
yeah,
her mattress, you
know. No, that's what she said. Shouldn't
her
have
back,
that her
honestly, I mean, for years, it's just been dogging her, but...
No, right, no, I know, she showed me her brace.
She
had me sign it.
She did, she's a survivor.
Yeah, you're
yeah,
great woman, that mother of yours. She just, if she could...
My dad, though.
Yeah,
I mean,
knew it. There,
you know, for years, he just took care of her and me, and she had the bath and the brace, and it's like, you can see the brace through a sweater, and he never said anything.
Yeah.
He just was, like, so sweet to her, and he was like, you look beautiful, and... It was sticking out.
Yeah. Karen, I hear you.
Yeah.
Your parents are sweet people, but honestly, like, as our sweet mates, like, for one, they should stay in that room. They don't actually have to keep coming visiting us. They're a bathroom away. They're a bathroom away. Like,
I mean, they just, you know, they love to have our little nightcap. I'm sorry, it's tradition. They loved you. I mean, if you want me to tell them.
No, I get it,
them.
They kiss me goodnight every night. I get, like, right on my forehead.
This is the year. This is the year I'm gonna bake a souffle and it's gonna be great.
Of course it's gonna be great. You just spent 3 years at cooking school.
Yeah!
You are ready for your souffle debut.
Mom and Dad are gonna be, their minds are gonna be fucking blown when they see the sweat I'm gonna make.
They're gonna be impressed because, I mean, after last Thanksgiving, I feel like you've really done a great job setting expectations low.
Yeah, yeah. I set it low, and that makes me angry, but this time I'm determined. It's definitely gonna happen, and if it doesn't, I'm just gonna be depressed all year again.
They look good.
Yeah, it's
they
looking great.
Really
it's
good.
It's rising. That's a good thing.
Should
I'm told.
Should I open it up and smell it?
No, we gotta let it bake.
Okay.
It's gonna, that could like deflate the whole process.
They look good. I mean,
it's rising.
Feel
just, it's rising just like our parents' expectations are gonna rise of me when I do this. Like, I'm gonna be a good son. So they love you. You're a good daughter.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I can cook.
Yes.
I've been cooking since the third grade. Remember when they came home and I was like, oh, good evening, welcome to my restaurant. But I served real food.
Yeah, and I was like the guy who like just came in like towels to like dry their hands on and like the water bowls.
Yes,
and the water
bowl. Too bad you spilled that on Mom.
Yeah.
That was really awkward. Nothing ruins a meal like Mom taking off her shirt and saying, I can't, I'm too wet, I'm done, and just going upstairs for the rest of the night. It really,
yeah.
I don't know. She missed
it's
dessert entirely. It was my first lawn.
I'm sorry.
I'll never have that moment back.
And
please, tell me how much you'll enjoy your first date moment.
It's gonna be great. And you know what? This time, like, it's gonna be both of our moments. Because you've been coaching me, you've been training me, and this time, like, I'm gonna impress them, and you're gonna seem even more impressive, too. Because I've just been learning so much from you.
That's really nice of you to say. I feel really bad about cutting the last page of the recipe out. They're not gonna rise.
What?
You know, I just didn't want you to have your moment. I wanted to ruin yours. This was my water bowl over Mom. You were gonna serve a bunch of little tiny Ritz cracker height souffles.
Okay.
I just thought, you know,
I didn't
risk it.
I didn't spill the water on purpose. It was always an accident. accent every time it's happened.
And I thought, because cousins really need to see each other, and we're hanging out again, we can get trucker hats and say number one cousin.
Oh god.
I have one too.
This, yeah.
Number one cousin.
This is cool.
We can fight for who's really number one.
Yeah. Let's stop. We're both. I missed you and hanging out. I miss us.
Oh, me too. This is awesome. We had to go to Austin, Texas just to see each other for once?
Yeah. Let's not wait that long next time.
Let's not wait that long next
time. Yeah. Let's move in together.
Are you serious? That's what I want.
Seriously?
You're going to move to Milwaukee?
I'll move to Milwaukee.
Are you serious?
Would you move to Austin?
I think about it.
Okay.
But if you're going to move to Milwaukee, why would I move to Austin?
Well, otherwise it'll be like, hello. Whoops.
Now you're
no one. I mean, yeah. If you're going to move to Austin.
This is why we're so funny together.
Yeah, but, you know, Austin's, you know, warm and, you could move to Austin, and I wouldn't have to move.
Oh yeah, it's so hot all the time. Good point.
Yeah,
because Milwaukee, it's just beautiful.
Just the two cousins in Austin going to shows.
Woo!
And eat barbecue.
One party in Austin.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's settled.
Milwaukee.
We'll get a little flat in Austin. Moving together to share my twin.
For, like, vacations. Yeah.
Yeah.
When we come back to visit.
Okay, look, I don't want to leave Austin.
I don't want to leave Milwaukee.
All right, well. Okay, so we seem to be at an impasse.
Yeah.
But I still, I love you.
I love you too.
I cook, right? And I'm not giving away the hat.
I'm kind of thinking of what that
I really think you should move. I mean, this is the last I'm going to say about it, but I really think you should consider moving to Austin.
Okay.
Okay.
No, okay.
Okay, cool.
Just 1 second while I consider it. And then while I'm considering it, maybe you'll consider moving to Milwaukee.
I will think about it.
We can just do that privately.
Just give me some space. Milwaukee. Where is Milwaukee, actually?
It's a bad one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Brought in the most beat up Oldsmobile I've seen. This side of Milwaukee.
Not much we can do for this one.
Yeah.
It's
gas leaking everywhere.
The tires are all flat.
No. Carburetor shot. Someone shot the carburetor, just.
Yeah. These people poaching Oldsmobiles out here.
Right? It's a disgrace.
Finding these old trucks and just shooting them up. What a shame.
And they took the steering wheel.
Ah, they blew it in two.
An important part.
what was that, Carl?
We all know you need the steering wheel. It's an important piece of
it. Oh, yeah. Yes.
You know, the mechanics, we're all aware of that.
Right.
First thing I learned about cars.
Wheel.
Steering wheel.
Yeah.
All the wheels.
That was the whole first semester.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times steering wheels, right? It takes a while.
It was kind of a confusing semester when they hadn't yet taught us about the locks on the door.
Yeah.
No.
We just had to admire it from the outside.
Staring through the window.
I could see it. I knew it was there. Just bunk.
Yeah.
Once they reversed the order, people were getting inside of the door and then putting their hands on the steering wheel much faster.
That was a rough fight.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right now I feel like I'm just a bit of a glutton for punishment. Thanks so much for having me. Yet again at a family Thanksgiving. Hey.
You're welcome.
I brought the turkey!
Yeah!
Oh my god, it's so great to have you!
I know!
Oh, good to see you, Miss Jane.
Honey, are you making me turkey again?
Yeah!
Oh, I love you so much.
Let's just get a sandwich.
Oh,
it's all good in here. It's all good in here.
Oh, that's a sharp break.
Oh.
Okay,
oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's how we show our love.
No, I know. I get that every night.
Let me get that.
Oh, yeah, of course.
This.
Everything for our daughter.
Come on in, son.
Come on in.
Son.
You're like a son to us.
Listen, they've redone
you know what?
The bedroom. It's now a den, so we're all gonna just get in the trundle.
Yeah.
Wait, I think we might be making him a little uncomfortable. I'm just gonna take a small aside.
Okay.
With the boy here.
That
come on over.
Is that what you guys did
over
last night?
It's gone for like half an hour.
Come on over and have a seat.
What's up, Mr. J? We're just so happy you're out here.
I know.
My wife, you know, she gets so worked up about all this stuff. It's just so much. I'm just glad you're here for me to talk to about this right now.
Yeah,
and my daughter, you just mean so much to her.
Yeah, nope, she tells me that a lot. She journals.
It's just
verbally,
that we've worked with her so much on all the therapy and just, you know, troubles that she had in school. And,
no, I get dragged along.
It's her blessing that she had such good support with her friends and when she went off to college and had the dark years.
Hey guys,
you want some water?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Except for this little
man
chat.
Oh,
yeah,
you're getting a little
jealous.
You're jealous.
Yeah.
Oh, nothing.
Sit on Dad's lap.
Tell you what, I haven't caught up with my daughter in a while.
Oh, okay.
Honey, do you want to take a seat and chat him up for a second?
All right.
I'm going to catch up.
Okay. Be good to him.
We were thinking of adopting you legally.
Okay.
Mom, Dad. This is my contribution to Thanksgiving this year. A flat souffle sort of pie thing.
Can you believe it? He did it all by himself.
Yeah, even after
I can believe that, yeah.
Even after all of Sherry's coaching. She trained me so hard I just couldn't get better. Isn't that look bad on her?
So. Yeah, so I mean what I'm hearing from that is that you didn't follow her instructions well.
I mean, what if there was like some sort of, you know, sabotage, like, you know, someone came in and messed my recipe.
All right. All right, Tyler, with the casting of aspersions on your sister, we all know.
Take that finger, turn it around.
Yeah, no. Right? All five of you, see that?
That's 10 fingers.
Right, and you dropped your crappy souffle, come on! Jeez.
I mean, you know, it's like, we try to be supportive, but it's just...
Jesus Christ and Mary.
Why don't you guys have a seat? I'll get the sides.
I just want to stand and look at it.
I'm eating it with my eyes. Oh, that's delightful.
I'm so mad at you, but it looks so delicious.
All right. Come on.
Just, okay.
Can you?
Yeah, pick up the crackers.
All right. Just take a breath.
We could save these for Duchess, you know.
Yeah.
We don't need those.
The dog.
Is that sweet potato?
Yeah.
She made sweet potatoes for the dog and for us. You are a delight. Set them down. I want to smell them.
We should have stopped at the first child.
Oh, man.
Do you love it? It's a cheese factory.
It's what we do here!
I'm blown away.
It's cheese.
Yeah, it's nice.
Everyone thinks about cheese when they come to Wisconsin. And
now I'm right. Now I'm thinking about it.
Yeah.
You got all kinds.
Yeah.
And this is what you do here?
Most of the time.
Nice.
Yeah.
Most of the time you go to cheese factories?
Yep. That's all people in Wisconsin do.
I know. Cool. You know, not to bring up old stuff between us, because I'm so excited to see you, and
it's been like
two, three years, and so much has changed in our individual lives.
Yeah,
I can't help thinking about all the diversity of foods in Austin. You know, they have tacos, barbecue.
Ah. I got some cheese on that, am I right?
Yeah, well, they do. Sometimes there is cheese. But no, I'm not. No regrets about moving here.
Great.
I don't have any regrets either.
Ding dong.
I'm taking employees.
I don't know how things work here yet.
I brought more cheese.
Oh, thanks. Do you work here?
Oh, I work at the store next door. This is how we welcome you.
Oh,
thank you.
Thanks.
We heard you were a tourist.
Oh, well.
So we brought some cheese.
See, I'm actually
So, I mean, but either way, thank you. This is very nice. More
very
cheese.
Very friendly place you've joined. Enjoy.
Yeah, thanks.
See, okay. Northern hospitality, that's a phrase. What's wrong, man?
No, nothing. Just, no, the cheese. No, the cheese is great. Nothing wrong with the cheese.
The Packers. Having a good season.
Yeah, it's the Packers. Yeah, disappointed in the Packers.
Oh, that sucks.
Ding dong!
Oh. So, Isaiah, you're expected to open tomorrow at 7.
Oh, thanks, guys. Sorry, I'm just punching in.
Oh, you're great.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I figure if we got people coming into the factory, we gotta give them the... Hey, stop moving.
Okay.
All right, just putting on the traditional Wisconsin helmet. It's a big block of cheese.
Got it.
And there's a.
Could you?
It's actually real cheese with a feeding tube, so if you could just take that in.
Could you
right
carve?
There.
Could you carve number one cousin on the side set?
Well, it's against OSHA regulations, but I'll do it for you guys. Yeah. New neighbors. Number one cousin. Oh gosh, that's gonna last a good 3-4 hours before it starts to stink.
Oh,
all right.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hey,
that's
welcome
amazing.
To the workplace.
Thanks. And so you're leaving now?
Oh yeah, that's what we do. In and out.
Great. You got a number one cousin.
You got a cheese helmet.
I'm starting to like it. This is kind of nice.
Oh.
I'm starting to. Yeah, I like how you you kind of have a responsibility to keep up other people's stores.
Yeah, you just kind of walk in places and it's like.
And then they you got the doorbell to get in their own.
You're in charge now.
But it's.
I trust
you. You know, the important thing is. You know, city aside.
Ding dong. Good. Didn't go there.
We'll have our emotional talk after.
Hey, I tell Owen Austin to advertise the Austin Music Festival, the greatest music festival on the entire earth.
Oh.
South by Southwest.
Yeah.
Extreme.
No, I've been there. I'm actually from Austin. I just moved.
Oh my
here.
God.
Yeah, I know all about South by
Southwest. Thanks a lot.
What?
People liked him, because I really hope that's true.
Yeah, I like you.
Oh, it is true then. That's great.
Yeah.
But when he's dead, it's liked.
Yeah,
right.
It's,
right.
Yeah.
It's still like right now.
So far, it's actually only person liked you.
Oh.
I feel like that.
Oh, okay.
There you go. You're good now.
Yeah. Yeah, I think mine. I just I want it to be as honest and straightforward. So like, mine's gonna just be something like. He was here, and he still is.
Yeah.
Right? Because like right where I'm dead, right there. I'm still there. Yeah, I'm sticking around. Dead.
Mine's just gonna say in the ground.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
very
literal.
Very correct.
Mm-hmm.
That's really good.
Yeah.
I think. I mean, that'd be a beautiful eulogy, really.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Just like get up there and kind of like they just drop you.
Yeah.
They just
drop
you.
The mic.
Right?
Yeah.
Like we were born, just dropped. In the ground.
Like one of those, like, when you're in a park ride, just...
Oh, yeah, that would be fun.
That's actually
yeah.
How I want to die.
Yeah.
So if you could just put that on my... Assuming I die before you guys.
Okay, yeah, probably.
Just be like, he died doing what he loved.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dropping off of a roller coaster.
Yeah.
Just let us know before you go riding. We'll get it prepped.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll sabotage
you.
Yeah.
How about you, Sam?
But
quiet.
Yeah. I was just thinking about how all of you are gonna die.
Hey, my parents disowned me after I ruined their Thanksgiving dinner. I heard your parents looking to adopt.
What?
Your parents like I heard from my friends, your college roommate, that your parents are like looking for new people to join their family, and I just need a new family real bad.
Just like spiritually and metaphorically, yeah, not like a real adoption. Did they say something about a real adoption?
Or just like add people to the family. Like, hey.
No, they want to adopt you. It's in the contract, all right? If I can get a swap out, I'm out of here.
Yeah, oh yeah.
If I can swap out, I'm out of here.
Please, no, any new family.
No,
he wants it.
Look at it. Oh, I'm bad.
Like it. like it there.
I mean, legally I'm obligated to say I love it, but I really don't.
I'll take his place. Like Indiana Jones style, we'll be just swapped.
You don't know what you're giving up.
I do know what I'm giving up.
And I'll take it.
I know more about what I'm giving up than you.
The cuddles, the noon cuddles.
And the five
kisses, one on each point of the face.
Oh, that sounds amazing.
the tuck-ins when you're napping.
Tuck-ins when I'm not napping. Like, they're always trying to put me in the back.
Sounds like they love them so much.
What about the tight squeezes when you go to the bathroom?
Man, you guys got Pearl Jam? This is awesome!
Woo! South by Southwest!
Yeah! Pearl Jam's still around!
Yeah, I got your beer. You know, it's not just cheese. Beer. Your beer, is Pearl
beer?
Jam.
Woo! Eddie Vedder!
Eddie Vedder, too! It's kind of like, this is cool. You're having a good time.
Good, I'm glad.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. We could turn this into a little more than just a vacation.
We could get number one cousin tattoos on our butts.